Hello and welcome. Thanks very much for joining. My name is Zane Vella. I'm the CEO at Sessions, and we're really happy to have a group joining us tonight to learn more about the Filmmaking and Digital Media program. And of course, thanks everybody for joining, and then also to our faculty and team for being here too to help answer questions. This really is a chance for folks who are interested in the program to meet Andre and to meet Andre, who's our program head, who's also teaching a few of the programs through the courses, and to also learn more about Sessions and how the program works. So I'll jump into it. We're going to start, like I said, we'll just do some quick introductions. I want to talk a little bit about who this program is really for. We'll look at the curriculum. We're gonna talk a little bit about, like I said, how it works, like how Sessions online education works, and then we'll look at some more of the faculty of the school. And this is Andre, who you're gonna learn more about. But I also want to take a moment just to share who else is here. We have the president of the school, Gordon.
Hello, everybody.
Thanks. And Vicky, who is running admission.
Hello, hello.
Let's really start with Andre. Before Andre gets a chance to talk about himself, just want to share a little bit about how exciting this program is, this filmmaking and digital media program is for us all at Sessions. It's the first new program that we are all working on as a team. And we've been really able to bring together a phenomenal set of faculty and partners. And I was fortunate to know Andre as a filmmaker and as an educator. And we were thrilled when he came on board to run our filmmaking department. So I'll tell you that Andre is not only a great filmmaker and storyteller, but a great teacher and a very generous soul in sharing what he's learned over his career. And so with that, Andre, take it away.
Ta-da. Well, and also to give you all the mystery of the film world, Zane and I are sitting here next to each other, so see if I can share. Thanks so much for that introduction, and I'm so glad you all showed up tonight and are interested in the program. This is a really exciting program that I feel great about. So I'm a filmmaker, a director, a producer. I use my films as tools to spark dialogue and conversation all around the country, and I found all kinds of ways to help my films to work towards changing the world, which is what I've been committed to since I was a little kid. And film has been the way I figured that out. I didn't go to film school. You know, when I was coming up, I'm the same age as Spike Lee, and I had the notion and thought and worry that going to film school would mean that I wouldn't have enough money to make a feature film, and I didn't want to be just somebody holding a mic for sound, which is not a bad career, but that was my perception and misconception, I should say, of what film school and what it all was back when I was in high school. So I didn't go. I got a master's in education. I taught in New York City. And through a long story that involves Spike Lee, Diana Ross, all kinds of people, and even a video for a country singer artist. I'm forgetting her name now. She sings that song, Man, I Feel Like a Woman. I worked on that video for 18 hours straight, that song blasting at top notch on a pier in Chelsea in New York City. Shania Twain. And was there doing craft services. When I showed up, I had no idea what craft services was, and I was there to do the best I could. So fast forward to today, you know, Sane approached me about working on this program, and I thought, okay, let's see what it's about. And I was tasked with creating the capstone course, the last class, which is the final product that out of the whole curriculum. After a year of work, you'll come to this one final class, and the whole idea is you're going to make a feature. And that can be talked about as we go along. And as I was preparing that class, I went through every single course in the program And I ended up being a few days, actually a week or so late at submitting my curriculum because I was so into the coursework that was involved leading up to the capstone class. And I'm a filmmaker, I make movies. I know how to do all this stuff, but there was so much more for me to learn. So I make movies. I'm right now in the fits and throes of a national major program campaign universe that is taking me in all new kinds of directions. And I'm literally learning every day. And I think that's what this program is about. And that's a great, exciting part of education. No matter how far along you are, you may be an influencer with thousands and thousands of followers, or someone with two or three followers, or someone that gets jobs consistently on film sets. And there's a way for you to actually learn more. And this program really is a structure, a place, a foundation full of good people that help you with that. So that leads right into this next question. Who does the program serve? Which I already touched into. I mentioned people who are influencers. I mentioned people who are directors, writers, editors. The idea with this program is that anyone that is interested in creating digital imagery and films can learn so much from this program. And I also will add this in, and this is a new one that Zane hasn't heard me say. This program is also for people who are fans of movies, you know, fans of digital content. The love and appreciation that I have of movies, of digital content, feeds my creative nature as I grow and develop and make and tell stories. So to run through this list, not all of them, but a few of them, a director or producer can get so much out of what does it mean to direct a film? What does it mean to understand what motivation behind every single shot means? And sometimes that can feel really intimidating. I know as a director, I'm like, oh my God, I got to do a shot list for every single moment. The great thing is, and that was a line that was under my picture in the last slide, we're here to teach you the science of filmmaking so you can move forward and do the art. You know, when you have that moment, and I had this moment today on a project, they said, I need a shot to do this. And I thought, I don't know how to do that, but I researched, I worked, I talked to people, and I learned it. And having my skill set that you will get from a program like this is what helped me to be able to make that next step and be able to learn it. So if I go all the way over to influencers, which I think we have one of them involved in the program we've been talking to, and you'll see some of his work later on. Influencers, you know, all these careers are money generating, income generating careers that can affect and improve and help your life. And we want to give the skill sets you can actually perform at them at your top level and understand how to make this work. So as an influencer, yes, you may know how to pick this up and make great work. And I like to say also, this camera is higher quality than a camera I shot my first feature on. And that's how much the world has changed. So influencers can actually come in and learn how to really understand beyond like, I'm going to make this cinematic, actually really dig into what does that truly mean to make something cinematic? Mm. This program will really help, I think, everyone that's listed on this slide here, and possibly some more that we may discover, really up their game and take it to the next level.
Yeah. I think what we wanted to share here around this program is that it really is, on one hand, great if you're an aspiring filmmaker or storyteller. If you're someone who's interested in learning filmmaking specifically for the traditional side of filmmaking, that idea of really, you know, writing a story and working with a large crew, whether that's an independent film or the idea of working in the industry, that this program will give you a great foundation in that. But we've worked hard to make sure that the program is also going to show you how to bring those principles and really everything that comes from filmmaking into today's world of digital media content creation. Because it's really having the foundation of filmmaking is a secret weapon for being able to make great content in today's world. And so we're going to go a little bit deeper into the curriculum now, so you really know what it is that you'll be diving into deep as part of the program. As we've talked about, it's a 24 credit program. So that 24 credits is designed to be done over two semesters. There certainly are options if you need to for your schedule to do fewer courses at a time. but it's really designed as a great intensive experience. And as a first semester, you're really building the, taking the foundation of everything you need to be a filmmaker or digital media creator, really from writing to editing to cinematography and directing. And we're going to go a little deeper into that. And you'll see then in the second semester, you're taking those basic skills that you've worked on and being able to, in that film 201 in the upper right, apply those concepts to platforms like Instagram or Twitch and other social media platforms. Mm-hmm. You'll work more on your fundamental writing, some film criticism, but you'll also then be able to work on that final project that Andre was talking about. And Andre will be the your instructor for that final project. Really, you'll have a key person to be able to work with and develop those ideas all the way through. Mm-hmm. So Andre, if you want to talk a little bit about the overview of the program, and then of course we have, you asked for cinematography as the example, so mm-hmm. we've got mm-hmm. that one teed up next.
Yeah, you know, so looking at the program, you basically have all the basic elements of what it means to understand how to be a content creator, how to be a filmmaker. We'll talk a little more extensively about what we'll do in the cinematography class and share one exercise. But, you know, the whole idea running through 101 is the intro, everything ranging from what are the various different types of shots that we can gather and capture to understanding what does it mean to make a cinematic actual image. Editing will be really hands-on, digging into how to work with Premiere and understand the program and the process and showing you some simple patterns and steps to get you started with editing. And then screenwriting, you know, if you don't have a story to tell, you're missing an opportunity to actually tell a story, you know? So really digging into what does it mean to write a screenplay and actually looking at actual formatting for screenplays based on over 100 plus years of history in Hollywood have a format. They have a font and a layout to make it a uniform exercise. And yes, you can be creative with your screenplay, but you want to understand how to prepare the proper screenplay to submit to the studios. And then directing, another class that I'm teaching, I mentioned that earlier, like how to understand what every moment of your storytelling is all about. And then I won't go through extensively in the second semester, but it's basically digging deeper into all that we talked about. And you'll see within these curriculum, this is why I got so, why it slowed down. All these classes, I should say, this is why I was late in submitting my work. They're so good. There's great films to watch. There's great information to gather that takes you right through, which takes us right to, look at this segue. This tag team is like perfect. The cinematography class at Film 101. So this course, and we're gonna show you a quick little piece from it, is asking that question, what makes cinematography of the great filmmaker so compelling? You know, what is it that when you watch, we all watch movies, that's why I said the line about being a fan. We all watch movies and digital content. What keeps you in it? You know, and there is a art to storytelling, but there's also a real particular science. And I will share this. So we're gonna show this rule of thirds course video as an example of how we illustrate and work. To stress once again, these classes are not sitting in a Zoom space like we're doing right now. They're project-based learning. We'll be giving an assignment and you'll get great feedback. But I am, as a learner, I am a visual learner. And I studied and read about the rule of thirds and I really did not get it until I had it drawn out and graphed out in a similar way to what this actual video presents.
Great. I'll tee it up. I'm just going to take one moment to explain a little bit. So at sessions, and we're going to share some more detail on this. The way things work is you have great materials online. So you can almost think about it as instead of a lecture, you're going to have great video, great text documents, great materials to be able to go deep into any of these subjects. And then each week you'll have projects associated with that material. And then as you do the projects, you'll get feedback. And we're going to go deeper. But what I want to start with is we'll share just an excerpt of some of the kinds of materials that you'll work with. And we partnered with a great group called Smashcut, who have built a lot of these. And we're very happy to be able to include them in our curriculum. So let's see, I have to make sure I get my sharing right here. So share, yeah. I'll go to this. Okay, I'll say share again, and hopefully you see that screen, and I'll go full screen, and then we'll say play. So again, this is an example of the kind of materials that there are many of throughout each of the courses.
Let's begin with what's the most basic template for thinking about image making. It's called the words is a way of dividing up an image with four evenly spaced lines, two horizontal, two vertical. Simply placing your elements along these lines makes for images that are pleasing to the eye, whether it's your subject or just the horizon itself. The off-center arrangement gives us an instant visual cue as to what's going on in the story and what the space means. It also feels organic and natural, not mechanically symmetrical. We're not just looking at equal portions of land and sky, wondering which is more important, but at one or the other, which grounds us and gives us an immediate point of view about the landscape. It can suggest a whole world outside the frame, not an artificial world trapped inside it. But there are always exceptions, given intention. Maybe, like in this shot, you want the viewer to feel as though they're being spoken to directly, and so you might decide to square up the camera with your subject, much like how you would center yourself in front of someone you're talking to. When characters in a narrative film talk to the audience, what's called breaking the fourth wall, you'll often find that they're centered in the frame for this reason.
Story of life is this. Static. One hand is always fighting the other hand.
Or maybe, like in the films of Wes Anderson, the filmmaker wants to evoke a feeling of whimsy by creating symmetrical compositions, which can often feel like visual jokes in and of themselves. But even Anderson uses the rule of thirds for effect. If you watch...
I'm gonna pause that there for a moment.
I'm glad we had that Do the Right clip in there. I worked on that film as a PA. And I'm actually in the fight scene, but no one can ever find me. And I never tell them where I am. It drives my students crazy. I love it.
Okay, I'm trying to get us back to the
sharing.
Get us back to the share.
That's good, yeah. Yakisha, see if you can find me in it. That's bonus points if you can find Teacher Andre and Do the Right Thing.
So that was a bit of a deep dive into, just go back for a sec. We really are just giving a taste of what is involved in cinematography and one specific course. You can imagine what you'll be doing through the program is a combination of those videos and written lessons and then doing projects. So we wanted to give you a sense also of one of those example projects. And so would you like to describe this cinematography project?
Sure, sure. So for this one, what we asked people to do, like that I mentioned earlier, you'll hear me say this again, about being a fan of films. And we asked people to pick three different interesting shots from a feature film that they like. This is what your assignment is. And then try to recreate the shot composition using your own subject and background. So you, by the time you get this exercise, you will have studied shot composition. You've studied different types of shots. And this is a chance to apply that science to your art. And this is, as you can see from this image right here, the student Patrick picked a scene from Kill Bill and just decided to recreate it. And he didn't use a sword, he used a broom in his house. And he had some lighting in his house that he played with. And the whole idea was just to recreate the scene. And it's, you know, this was done in his room after putting his kids to bed. Like that is the joy and the beauty of what can happen with a Sessions College class. We can really fit into your lifestyle and your time, thus it being project-based and the like, but I'm jumping ahead of myself. But that's what the project example I'm gonna show here is.
That's great. Maybe I'm gonna hold off so I'm not doing all of that screen sharing, jumping back and forth. I'm gonna go, so this is just an example of the project, but the really important part about the way the experience works is the feedback from professionals like Andre and other faculty. So as you work on a project, so you're exposed to, you're able to have access to these videos and the great classes, and then you get a project assignment, and then you deliver the project, you upload the project you've made, and then you get feedback from the instructor, personalized feedback, really looking carefully at what you've made and really thinking about what your skills are and being able to give you that feedback, and not just rah-rah encouragement, really recommendations that as professionals, they see about how to improve your work. And the whole point, and this everything at Sessions works this way, is about you being able to build your own portfolio, you being able to build a collection of work that you can show to potential employers, and it really is through projects and working that you build up your skills. So this is just a quick look at some example dialogue in a related project.
Mm-hmm. And I'll jump in and say that as a professor, it's actually really great to be able to give feedback to people developing their work. My approach to teaching is I'm also learning as I teach. And I think all the instructors we have in here are folks who have long careers, who are professionals, who really care about helping you understand how you can grow and develop. And something I stay committed to with being a filmmaking teacher or a digital content teacher is what can I deliver that I didn't have as a student? And with the roles changing so much and so quickly, there's so many opportunities to offer out all kinds of new information and to learn and grow together.
But it's also very much what I meant about the generosity that Andre brings as an educator. Like I've seen the kind of feedback that works when you're learning, and I've seen the kind of feedback that doesn't, and really is it's a joy when it works, and we're excited about the class that's coming together, and hope that some of you listening now will be able to join us in that great loop of projects and feedback. We'll take a minute to share some of the other faculty. So that you have a sense of who you're going to be getting that feedback from. So in addition to Andre, who's teaching directing and the final projects, cinematography, screenwriting, editing are all also taught by very experienced professionals. If you want to share anything about the department.
This is our department, which I'm so psyched to work with. And they're all really great, fantastic people who are once again just committed to helping you learn. I will say this, I can speak for me and maybe for Tim also, we don't have to do this, we want to do this. You know, we have busy lives and making time for this is important for all of us and we enjoy it for that reason. You know, Valeria, who's our cinematography class teacher, it's a lot to get out, big word. It's just fantastic. She brings a really great international perspective. Her work is absolutely beautiful. She understands how to get the shot. She understands what it means to make film. And as you can see, she's won numerous awards all around the world, which is really exciting. Jumping over to Tim, and I got to be honest, Tim is a friend of mine. Tim and I met, I think, when he was working on the poster for, oh my goodness, having a senior moment, the poster for Quentin Tarantino's first movie, not the second movie, but second movie.
Pulp Fiction.
Pulp Fiction. Thank you. See how we collaborate? We work together. Tim and I, that's how long ago it was. We both were working at Miramax, and Tim was a graphic designer. And I had been a teacher and had jumped into Miramax. We both were on this path to become filmmakers. And we both spent our years at Miramax doing all kinds of stuff and left all of that to actually be filmmakers. Tim has won numerous awards and has made some incredible movies that are really fantastic. It's worth Googling all these people to look at their work and witness and see. And so Tim will be joining us on the screenwriting class. He's a director and a screenwriter and really understands it. A former professor at USC and just will come top notch. And we have Natalie, who has been involved with Sessions College for a number of times, who will really lead you through a practical skill making of how to learn and be an editor. I gotta admit, I'm afraid of editing. It's not my skill set. I'm a director, a producer. I'm good at concepts, ideas. I walked away from ticking through the editing course as I was building out my capstone class, the final course, and I learned a couple of things. I was like, okay, I can do this. So everyone there really cares about being here, will give you strong, good, powerful feedback, and will be present and available for you through the program with their feedback and information. And I just really care about you learning and offering to people the chance to get that science down so you can actually move towards the art.
Thank you, Andre.
Well, pleasure.